down from 20 or so programmes to substantially less. So much of the long-term care needs to go through neighbourhoods in terms of that development there and the role primary care networks will play within that, and there will be very much definite must-dos for those primary care networks, which will be aligned to planned care, essentially around cardiovascular disease, case finding, respiratory condition management and so on. We must also remember that there's long-term conditions management within children's services as well, particularly with children with complex needs. Mental health itself is a long-term condition, and urgent care is where we can remember unplanned care as a scheme. So the purpose of bringing them together as portfolios is actually they should actually talk to one another, not work in silos, and interact with one another through the portfolio management group and the portfolio partnership board. As part of that, internally, World Health and Care Commission will be holding three events, to which are all organisation events, so every single person employed by the organisation in a non-clinical or clinical role has been invited to attend those, and that, the purpose of that is to socialise the plan with every member of the team, every member of the organisation, so they not only know what they are doing, but they know what the person sitting next to them is doing, and they know what the person sitting on the floor below them is doing. So people cannot say they didn't know this was happening. They don't know, we cannot say they don't know what the priorities of the organisation are for 1920, and they don't understand how we then start to subsequently develop the 5-year recovery plan, which sits very much alongside
and any other questions, comments? I think this Healthy Wirral work is important for us to understand across both of our committees in common, because this committee in common really is the commissioning strand of Healthy Wirral, if you consider the governance. So we are part of this work, so it's really important we do understand it. So thank you for the update, and I'm sure more will come in the future. Now, as you can see from that, that diagram that was referred to on page 33, as has been discussed before, neighbourhoods are an important part of the Healthy Wirral work, and so Graham, I think you're going to give us an update with governance. I apologise there, so when things go on the screen, I know they're behind you, I'm sorry about that.
In the new parks, there is a presentation and we'll get a pre-presentation. I guess the key thing here is to offer the opportunity for people to ask questions. I will attempt to bring things a bit more up to date as well, because things have moved on quite a lot in the last few weeks since this presentation has been within the pack. So again, I'll try to bring things up to date in as far as I can. But I guess today really is, this is something we haven't discussed in detail here, but I thought it was important to illustrate how the Healthy Wirral programme is being built in one of the concepts. I've done about two things at the same time, so it's multitasking, so very important. So neighbourhoods, the key thing about neighbourhoods is they are about people and where they live, as opposed to other constructs. And when we first worked through what a neighbourhood was, we based that on what I call low super urban areas, or in essence, communities where people live. So that was the starting point for neighbourhoods. And I think that one of the key things about that is that we want to be able to ensure that we work in such a way that maps a whole range of things about people from primary care through to voluntary sector, through to developing industry and opportunities for people on a knowledge basis. So it's much broader than just the care and the significantly broader agenda. And the neighbourhood approach will link with how we work in terms of we're all together as a whole system in Wirral, as well as in the Healthy Wirral agenda. So it's quite a significant shift. Having said that, one of the big changes recently is that NHS England are looking for primary care networks within a neighbourhood model. And one of the key things that's being worked on at the moment is what primary care networks look like. And we're trying to get those as close to the neighbourhood model as we can. A few principles in terms of what place-based working is all about. So it's very much about that much broader picture. But it's also moving away from having a centralised control system to a localised control system where decisions are made locally that make sense to people in that area. But that's really important in a place like Wirral where priorities for different areas can be very different for the local population. And approaches in terms of meeting health inequalities mean that we have to target the approach significantly in different areas as well. So that one size fits all is not